craft beer. And it bothered me that, you know, growing up, we were only exposed to one kind of beer, which was commercial lagers. So I said to myself, you know, why not offer something that's different? You know, show Filipinos what beer can be.
It's a wonderful story, right? Make wonderful, world-class beer. The fun part of the job is that you do need to have a palate.
Hence, lots of drinking here. Welcome to Encanto Brewery here at Carmona, Cavite. I'm Ian Paradis, the founder of Encanto.
And I'm MJ, brewmaster of Encanto Brewery.
Firstly, we want to say happy Valentine's to everyone. For those of you either single or dating, please feel free to come and join other couples as we have a brewery tour. Please come in. In my opinion, the most important thing is the team we have. MJ's a world-class brewmaster. We're lucky to have him here in the Philippines with us. Luckily, his wife is Filipina, so we're able to lock him in. Most people don't realize that I'm Filipino, but I actually grew up in Cebu. And the reason why I chose the name Encanto, you know, I love the stories growing up of Chanaks, Aswangs, Duendes. I was scared, terrified, but I also love that whole cultural side, you know, the belief in mysticism and folklore and superstition. And Visayas kind of being the center of that in the Philippines. So I chose the name Encanto as an ode to that. We'll give you a bit of background on the ingredients we use for our beers before proceeding into the brewery itself.
Yeah, so first of all, when we talk about craft beer, there's four core ingredients. So water, of course, malt. So this is an example of what malt can look like. And then we need hops. These are hop pellets here, give the bitterness and aroma and flavor to the beer. And then, of course, we need yeast. That's the fourth ingredient.
People always ask us what the yeast is for in beer making, and it's really what gives you, what converts the sugars into alcohol.
Without yeast, we just have a barley tea that's hopped. But we'll head into the brewery now.
It's actually quite funny. Most people, when they think craft brewery, they think they're going to be walking into parang a garahe, my garahe, and see us doing, you know, different recipes in a small system. And I think people get shocked when they see realize the scale of the brewery.
So we'll head to the brew house first. It's where we kind of start the process off. Actually, step up on the brew house platform, get a closer look. So this is our four-vessel, 50-barrel, or 60 hectoliters equals 6,000 liters of beer. But when we start the process off, we start with our malt. We bring the malt in to the brew house for the first process, which is mashing in. Dumped into that vessel, and we're adding hot water. We're starting to convert those sugars, get a lot of flavor. So we have seven fermentation tanks. They're all double batch tanks, meaning they can hold almost 12,000 liters. As we're filling that tank, we need to add that last ingredient, the yeast, which we've talked about, and then fermentation starts. So the sugars are converting to alcohol. Essentially, fermentation will last about 7 days. Every day, the lab's testing it. So we have a sample port here. It's still kind of rough beer at this point, so there's not a lot of sensory, but a lot of testing. So after fermentation, we need to filter the beer. So we'll walk over to the filter over here. So it kind of looks like a weird R2-D2 or something. Running it through a plate screen system here that has filter media added to it, and we're removing yeast or any proteins from the beer. So at this point, we have finished beer, polished beer, sometimes what we call bright beer, but it's ready to be packaged. So we're lucky today that we're actually bottling some beer. So we're bottling Mango Nation Hazy IPA. It was filtered yesterday. It's actually in this tank here.
This is my favorite part of the brewing process because I love the noise. It makes you feel like you're in a manufacturing plant hearing the bottles.
So we're bottling about 100 bottles a minute, 6,000 bottles an hour. So bottles come in, they go through a labeler. So we're adding this wraparound body label in this machine right here. So it continues around empty. It's actually working its way to the filler. So these pedestals are coming up, moving around, getting filled, exiting right here. There's a little bit of foam. We want to make that foam kind of spark up. And then right here, we hit it with the capper. Finished goods, bottles coming to the case packer. A little bit of a busy day. We got some incoming goods. Later today, we'll have some outgoing goods, so we're a little bit full, but we keep all the finished beer back here in our cold room. So it's pretty full at the moment. We're bottling pretty heavy right now in anticipation for a big export order to the US. It's also my favorite spot in the brewery if I'm really hot, like I am now. I like to go do a little walk to the cooler and check on finished goods. So this is our quality assurance laboratory. So we'll step inside and see if they're doing any testing, which they probably are. All right, so this is our laboratory, which is quite important in any brewery. Brewing is science at the end of the day, but craft brewing kind of implements a lot of kind of creative input, kind of artistic approach. A lot of science happening in here. There's a lot of testing, but tasting is also important. And we do sensory training to make sure everyone's palate is kind of refreshed once in a while, and we can distinguish off notes and make sure our beer is just as good as possible. Yeah. So we'll move to our R&D room here.
This is actually where I first learned to brew when we started, before we even launched the company, when we started to develop the recipes before launch. This is the system I learned to brew in.
Lots of fun activities in here. It's our little playground for experimentation.
And the great thing is it's super economical because it's small quantities. If things don't go the way you want, you're not wasting too much raw material time. So this is really where we have a lot of fun kind of experimenting. And a lot of us have different ideas. So we take all the different ideas of the different team members, not just from the operations and brewing side, but also from sales, marketing, because they are familiar with what customers are looking for. So this is kind of where we put those ideas to the test.
I think even our accountant has one beer idea that we're gonna do for her. So it's a full team. The company has grown. We have a serious facility here to make world-class beer, and that's the goal. We want to educate people. Let them ask questions, smell, taste, touch the ingredients. It really just kind of opens their eyes to beer and craft beer.
I think people get a better appreciation of like the process that we go through in order to make the beers they drink.
No? Yeah.
And I think what people love is after the brewery tour, the walkthrough, they get to come, you know, and have beers paired with food and interact directly with MJ, and you get a mix of large groups, groups of just a few people, or even individuals coming by themselves and making new friends, meeting people. So it's super fun and engaging and interactive. And I highly recommend it, especially if you're a big beer fan or you're interested in kind of what goes into making beer, to join one of our brewery tours. I guess what better way to celebrate Valentine's together than over a nice glass or many of beers and food with other people that are just as enthusiastic as you are in the tour. So I think it's a great way to spend it, and it's something different. I think with Valentine's, many times people expect to go to a restaurant, right, or a hotel. This is something completely different from that. So I think it's unique.